Chip Conley, the founder of Joie de Vivre Hospitality, the second largest boutique hotel chain in the world, is also a huge fan of Abraham Maslow. In fact, he's written books on Maslow's hierarchy of needs and does lectures on the subject. Chip is a firm believer that business frames financial incentives in the wrong light. They're important, very much so, but not the be-all, end-all.
We pay average in the hospitality business. The hospitality business doesn't pay that well. So we're average in an industry that doesn't pay well. Our average turnover, though, as a company is 25%, which may sound high, but in our industry it's 60 to 100%. So our average turnover as a company is 1/3 to 1/4 the average. Why is that? It's partly because when it comes down to it, people stay in their work and they stay with who they feel loyal to, not because of the company, that's part of it, but it's actually based upon the people that actually they have relationships with within the company. And that could be their boss, that could be their coworkers. If you feel like you're actually treated well and people like you and you feel good about the work you do, you feel good about the reputation of the company, you feel some meaning in what the organization maybe does in the community, the fact that you get paid 2% less than the competitor down the street means that, you know, when they come you know, asking if you want a job for 2% more, you're gonna be giving up all that other stuff. And that other stuff is part of what actually helps people to stay in their work. And I think that most business leaders sort of lose that. They actually get very tapped into what's most easily countable, which is, you know, how much are we paying them? And that's one ingredient, but it's not the most important ingredient.
With a mixture of hourly employees, executives, salespeople, union workers, and non-union workers, Joie de Vivre incorporates many different types of incentive plans.
A lot of hotel companies actually do provide the opportunity for an employee to actually go stay for a discount, or maybe once a year you get to go and stay in a hotel for free. Well, we do it twice per quarter. Now, why do we do that? Number one is we have perishable assets, which means that we have hotels that aren't always full. And every night that they're not full, we didn't get some benefit out of it. And if someone's not going to be paying to stay in a hotel room, I'd love to have one of my employees stay there for free as a benefit.
For companies like Joie de Vivre, who are constantly looking to monitor the customer experience, these perks can serve a dual purpose.
But for the employee, it actually allows them to go and experience the other side of the counter. We're used to providing service. What's it like when someone's providing service to me? And how do I actually notice the things that we're doing right and wrong at that particular hotel? And how's that going to influence me when I go back and do my work? And so, long story short is sometimes the best perks for an employee are those that don't have to cost a lot, but actually have some meaningful benefit to them, not just in their pocketbook, but also in terms of enriching them and educating them.
Ultimately, what separates a world-class organization is its ability to take care of its people through both the good times and the bad.
Most of us who get excited about Maslow's hierarchy of needs get excited at what's at the top of the pyramid, the peak of the pyramid, self-actualization. But if there's a real good lesson about a pyramid, it's that the foundation's got to be strong. If the foundation's not strong at the base of the pyramid, you never get up to the top. So during the last downturn, which was the dot-com bust and post 9/11 period, where frankly we were the largest Bay Area hotelier in a region that was seeing the largest percentage revenue drop in the history of American hotels, we were in a lot of trouble. And what became clear to me is that in order for our employees to have their survival needs met at the bottom of the pyramid, we needed to give them a sense that they weren't going to lose their jobs. And we chose instead to say, okay, I didn't take a salary for 3.5 years, and all of our senior executives took a 10% pay cut, and every salaried employee in the whole company took a 2.5 year pay freeze. But by taking those measures, it allowed our line level employees who made just an hourly wage at the bottom of the pyramid to actually know that they had a job and they got actually their benefits, and they know that annually they got a wage increase, and everybody actually felt like they were in a better place. Because the number one emotion in most companies in America today is fear, and fear is not a great motivator. It's great to run away from a tiger, sort of our survival needs as, you know, very instinctual needs, but it's not great for running a company that's in a marathon, because you get burned out if you're too adrenalized all the time. And that's what happens in most organizations. And so, you know, we learned during that downturn that actually helping our line level employees feel secure and safe actually helped them to perform better.